Hi Harpers, welcome to Let's Talk Harp. I'm Tiffany Schaefer, and today I want to start off by thanking Retha, Andrea, and Jennifer for becoming my newest patrons. Thank you so much. And I wanted to remind them and all of you, if you are a patron, that our workshop and concert is going to be tomorrow. And this is a patron-only workshop and live YouTube concert. And it is my way of saying thank you to all my wonderful patrons for helping me reach my goals. And there's a link down in the description and also across the screen here where you can sign up to be a patron for any amount and you'll be able to join us. So, story time. Last summer, I was at the Scottish Games, which is not unusual, and I was performing on the stage with my husband on the competition stage. And I had a realization that seemed to me at the time very profound. And that realization was, I was competing, and I was having fun, and I wasn't nervous. Now, this is not to say I never enjoyed performing before. I know I have, and I'm sure I did. But especially when I was a beginner competing, you know, about 10 years ago, and even less time than that, it was hard, especially to play something fast when you know there are people watching you and literally judging you. So when I was on that stage and I realized that I was really enjoying this and I was even playing fast things and having fun and wasn't crippled by nervousness, I started thinking on what had happened in my life to get me to that point. And disclaimer, this is not to say that I have conquered all stage fright and I never get nervous anymore. That's absolutely not true. But I do feel I am getting better at it. So as I was reflecting on the things that have helped me, I want to share them with you. So here are just four different categories, things that might help you with your performance anxiety or your stage fright. One of the things that has helped me is to observe and emulate. Observe the performers that you admire. This could be someone that you have seen in concert or someone you follow on YouTube or Facebook. If you have someone that you admire, and I'm not saying to become an exact copy of them, I'm not saying to copy their personality or their playing style, but just to sort of look at them and see how it's done. If you have no stage presence, for example, like I used to have no stage presence and I am still working on my stage presence. What I think of when I think of stage presence is connecting with your audience, even if you don't say a whole lot, but just to talk to them a little bit in between songs, to look at them, to just have that connection with them and not to seem shy and into yourself. True story, once several years ago, I was playing at an Irish fest that my friend was helping coordinate. She had set me up with it. And I got up on that stage, this was years ago, and I wasn't singing with the harp back then. I was just playing music. And I started playing a few songs and there were people watching and I wasn't singing. I didn't say anything. I didn't say a word on that stage. And it just felt kind of really awkward. Chances are you can probably think of someone right now who has a good stage presence that you admire. They look at the camera or the audience, they speak or sing clearly, they smile, they don't look nervous, they look like they're having fun. The idea is if they can do it, you can do it. So it can be really helpful to just see what that looks like and when it's all put together, and it can give you something to aim for. And by the way, if you want to see someone who looks like she's having so much fun when she's playing the harp, I've never seen this one look this happy when they're playing the harp, is you should look up Harriet Iris, and I'm going to put a video up in the cards for you so you can see what I'm talking about. Just see if I'm right, okay? Now, you might see yourself as someone who does not have a great stage presence, and you're nervous all the time, and you're just thinking, I can't pull this all together at once, out of nowhere. So I would say just focus on one little thing at a time. The next time you have a performance, just pick one thing that you think would enhance your performance. If you have trouble talking to your audience, for example, you can just try saying something to introduce your piece. If you always look grumpy while you're playing and you're tense, just focus on smiling. Just one thing at a time. Another thing that has helped me a lot is cameras. Just videoing myself while performing. I look at this as sort of the gateway into performing live. It's just amazing how much it helps. It's a good way to put all of that into practice that we just talked about with the stage presence and everything, but you have the comfort of your own living room. If you mess up, you can start again. It's kind of amazing how much it simulates like a real audience, like there's an eye watching you. But I kid you not, if you want to get into sort of a boot camp for getting over stage fright, I highly, highly recommend recording yourself and doing it regularly. And do not keep them to yourself. Share the videos on YouTube or another social media platform. And you don't have to start a fancy channel and get a million subscribers. I mean, you can if you want to go for that, go for it. But you don't need an expensive camera or a microphone. You can just use your phone. You could do something simple like record one of your favorite pieces maybe once a month, or just have that goal. It doesn't have to be every day or every week, but just to put it out there for people to see and upload it onto your Facebook or YouTube page. They're both free. They're not hard to use, and it doesn't have to be a long video either. And I think the best way to use this is to look straight into the camera. Yes, I mean position the video so we can see your face. And smile, introduce your piece before you start playing, then play it. And remember, you can record it as many times as you want if you make a mistake. You can say something just simple, like, hi, I'm blank, I'm going to play, or I have just played blank, and it was arranged by blank. That's it. That's all you have to do. So if you do this on a regular basis, first of all, it will give you incentive to learn and polish new pieces. And secondly, when you have gotten over your camera shyness, you are well on your way to getting over your stage fright. And if you want to see an example of this, go watch my first video on this channel where I actually sang and talked to the camera at the end. It's down by the Sally Gardens. I'll link it up above for you. And I hope you can see that I've come at least some way in being comfortable with the camera. And I can't stress this enough. Don't underestimate the value of talking to your audience and talking to the camera. I'm not kidding, it opens you up. It's part of performing, and I think you'll notice if you talk to your audience, whether that's live or on camera, and get used to it, it'll help other aspects of your performing. Now, if you're someone who's terrified of recording yourself and you've never done it before and you just get nervous every time you turn on that camera, you might want to start with little stages. You could start with just a voice recorder on your phone and just record the sound. And once you get used to that, you know, just maybe have a video up, but just record your hands. Once you get used to that, you know, put your face in there. Once you get used to that, start introducing your piece, just talking to the camera a little bit. And like I said, it is valuable also to share these with other people, not just keep them to yourself. Although it's still helpful if you know, even if you never share them. But I would encourage you really to put them out there. And if you really want to challenge yourself, play something over Facebook or YouTube Live. Just make sure you don't knock over your harp in the process. And as a bonus, when you record yourself, it is really helpful to improve your technique because you're actually listening to yourself and you are looking at your hands from a different angle. It's very helpful. It's a win-win. The next tip is just to perform as often as you can. This is not new advice, I know, but honestly, it's one of the best things I can think of is just to help you get over your stage fright is just to do it. Just do it over and over and over as often as you can, especially in a non-competitive, friendly sort of atmosphere. If you're not used to it, you may like to try being background music, such as for a cocktail hour at your friend's wedding, or a dinner, or maybe for a graduation party or a birthday party in your family. And it doesn't have to be a fancy white tie event either. You can play for your church, you can play for your friends in your living room, you can play for your family. One family member or a bunch of them. It all counts. It all counts in helping you get just exposure to playing for other people. I've been very fortunate to find a local open mic at my Irish American Club, and it's a very sweet and casual atmosphere, and people get together and try numbers together, sometimes the night of, and everyone's casual and friendly. So maybe you can check for local Facebook music groups, or your community center, or you might find something like that. Or even sometimes local restaurants, small, you know, sandwich places, or Irish pubs will have a stage or even sessions where musicians will get together and play. So ask around, don't be afraid to call places and see what you can find. Some people I know are nervous playing for other musicians or with other musicians. Now, this is just my experience, but I think as a general rule, folk musicians tend to be some of the most friendly, encouraging, supportive, sweet people that I have ever met, and I mean that sincerely. You have an instant connection with them because they get it. They get the love of music. They like to play it too. Most of them are not looking to judge you or your music. They just appreciate what you're doing, and they will often want to make music with you. Especially if they're not harpists, they think you are magic, okay? So don't be nervous to play in front of other musicians. They want you to do well. Maybe sometime I'll make a video on playing with other musicians. Give me a thumbs up or leave me a comment if you want that video to happen. Another idea is, if you want a very appreciative audience, is to call up a local nursing home or a retirement community and volunteer to play a few numbers for them. They will love you. No matter what level you are at, if you've never played for anyone before, trust me, they will love you. And in my experience, you may have to call up the activities director a few times because they tend to get busy, but keep at it, and I think it will be worth your time. And if you want some more great ideas for places or people to perform for, check out Christy Lynn's video. I'm going to put that up in the cards too. She has a lot of great ideas for different places to perform, and I'm sure there's a place for you. My last tip is to try and change your attitude. You may have heard the saying that amateurs practice until they get it right, but professionals practice until they can't get it wrong. And I think practice is great and all, and knowing a piece really, really well is very important to help curb those performance nerves. But I also think that once you've given into that nervous, jittery feeling on a stage, that sometimes even something you know backwards and forwards at home just flies out of your head or flies off the page and you can't concentrate. But if you can get to the point where you're calm and enjoying yourself from the beginning, you're more likely to remember or to improvise even if you forgot a spot. Plus, I think it's important to remember that sometimes you can't be fully prepared. Sometimes you just don't have enough time to adequately practice. You might get asked to do an encore that you weren't prepared for. It's a great thing to be in such a comfortable place that you can pull out something that you know that you weren't going to play and maybe haven't even played in a few days, but just to be free to be able to do that is a really good feeling. And this can happen. Positive thinking is very important. And if you try and change your attitude about the performance, I know for myself, if I think this performance is just the be-all, end-all to my harp career, and if I've had it in my mind, I've just staked everything on playing well, I must do well, there's no other option, this is my identity. Do you think I'm going to be nervous about doing well? Yes. That is an enormous amount of pressure to put on myself, and the thing is, it's unnecessary pressure. So let me just try and reassure you, if that's you, nothing is worth that amount of worry. If you can get yourself to practice thinking about it that way, no performance is worth robbing yourself of that peace of mind. It's not. I know that's easier said than done, but if you catch yourself starting to think this way, just try and replace it with the thought, I am going to do my best, I'm going to serve these other people with my music. And I'm preaching to myself too, I have not got this down yet. So don't idolize your performance to the point where it's all that matters, because it's not. Even the professionals who have practiced till they can't get it wrong, have slip-ups, have bad days, they still make mistakes. So if that happens to them, why should I worry if it happens to me? And if you can allow yourself the freedom to make mistakes, that just takes the pressure off of you. If you don't have to be perfect, I think you'll be less nervous. Now, that may be a lot to think about when you're in the middle of a song. So if you are in the middle of a performance and you find yourself starting to have that thought, you know, this is my trouble spot, I'm going to mess this up, and then I'm going to mess up everything after that, and it's going to be terrible, try just diffusing it with a smile. Just force yourself to grin or smile a little bit, because sometimes that, just the act of smiling, will relax you and make you less tense and help you play more smoothly. One more thing I think may be helpful to you, just taking a moment before you begin to perform, warm up your hands if they're cold. You can place them on the back of your neck, and that usually works because it's no fun playing with cold hands, I'm sure you know. And just breathe a little. You know, you can do this while you're sitting at your harp stool. You don't have to begin playing as soon as you sit down, okay? Just remember that. So if you are someone who wants to perform but stage fright just has its grip on you, I would encourage you to just take those little steps and don't give up on yourself. Think back to the reason that you started to play the harp or any instrument if you're not a harpist. This is fun. They call it playing for a reason. So sharing your music with others really can help open up a new world for you. And I believe you could get there. Thanks for coming along and watching this video. If you're a patron, don't forget about our concert and workshop tomorrow. And I will see you all next week for more songs, tunes, and harp tutorials. Bye-bye.